सत श्री अकाल, नमस्कार, नमस्कारमु, वनक्कम। वेलकम टू माइक्रोस्कोप एंड फोल्डोस्कोप चैनल सीरीज पार्ट 5 इन द थीम ऑफ माइक्रोस्कोपी इज द आर्ट ऑफ नॉलेज ए विंडो टू अनदर वर्ल्ड। दिस लेक्चर इज कंडक्टेड इन द प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ साइंस एंड आउटरीच एक्टिविटीज ऑफ CSIRCSIO चंडीगढ़ chapters Jigyasa, OSA, IEEE and SPY. Apart from these societies, this theme of microscopy and foldoscopic channel lecture is also be a part of International Year of Light, which is conducted by UNESCO. I, Dr. Vemuri SRS Praveen Kumar, completed PhD in Optical Coatings, presenting the lecture of Microscopy is Art of Knowledge on the topic of microscopy of mosquito. So in this topic we are understanding the difference between the mosquitoes which is surrounded nearby home and what are the different kinds of mosquitoes and how we can find the basic knowledge of the mosquitoes in which it can be harmful for our human need. This mosquito structure was seen under foldoscopic technique developed by Manu Prakash in earlier days. So here the foldoscopic product which I used is 00025E6172FA. So the aim of lecture shows that some of the important features of mosquitoes can be understand. Varieties of mosquitoes surrounded nearby home in vacant space or in dustbins was collected and seen the microscopic images of that one. Here are the three images, three mosquitoes. You can see the structures of the three mosquitoes are different. So what and how is the important, what is the things which we can understand. So to see the macroscopic view of the mosquito, I have used the 10x magnification lens. So in that I have collected three different kinds of mosquitoes which is showing in such a fashion in the macroscopic view with having 10x zooming lens. So the sample preparation I have shown in this present slide. I have taken the tweezer, I have taken one mosquito and magnification lens. This is the sample box where you can see different kinds of mosquitoes I have collected. Wherever it is coming on the morning section or in the night section, the mosquitoes will be different. This is the three sample slides, plastic sample slides in which I can place the mosquito and we can go for viewing the macroscopic view. So this is the four leg of the mosquito. 1, 2, 3, 4 patterns will be there here. This is the head portion, this is the wing portion. Every mosquito's wings are different, two different one. So my upcoming presentation will be on structure of wings in which we can understand basic difference and how the flies will be fly in such a manner. So with that we can understand the aerodynamics portion of mosquitoes or aerodynamics portion of flies. That is the upcoming lecture series of mine. I hope that lecture will be useful to all the students. So coming to the part of the present lecture, this slide shows the different kinds of mosquitoes and their leg views. You can see there is the dot portion, white portion, dot portion, white portion. In some mosquitoes there is no dot portion and white portion. What is this difference and what are the views we can understand by seeing this lecture. So here if you see the leg, one leg of mosquitoes in macro image under the 10x magnification lens, if you see there are white portions there, I understand that there is no hair was grown. The mosquito has not having any hair particles at the white portion. That's why there is a difference like interference pattern of bright and dark fringes. Difference patterns are shown in this image. In this microscopic view, the same thing can be visualized, and it has been proved. So this, in this black portion, there are more number of hair particles as compared to the white portion of the leg of the mosquitoes. This is the proof of the microscopic view taken from the foldoscope. So this is the leg structure. You can see clearly how many hairs or how many particles or how it is looking in such a manner. This is the one end of the leg to another end. This is the portion where the mosquito will be hanging this leg. Now the starting, it is going to is the end portion. This is the middle portion, how this horns, like very fine horns to do these mosquitoes things. So this is the end portion, that four leg portion. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4 different kinds of structures are there. In another section, we can see the microscopic view of black and white color portion of mosquito leg. So this is the white portion of the microscopic view of mosquito leg. It has been clearly visible what is the difference and how the variation is looking in this video of the mosquito leg. So this is one more mosquito leg. See how much thin leg can be seen clearly under the foldoscope of product. So friends, by understanding the differentiation between the microscopic views and macroscopic view, one can understand the phenomena of what kind of mosquitoes are coming in and around us, and how we can take over into a good health purpose, and how we can take into action by spraying mosquito repellent solutions or mosquito repellent coils we can use. So identification of male and female mosquitoes can be described in this particular slide. So male leg is far left, we have seen here, far left portion is there, and female will be in the far right portion. One simple difference between male and female mosquitoes are size of the mustache. Both of them have bushy mustache, but male is having more bushy. So this is called as Johnson argon and is used to enable hearing. So using this bush and mustache, these mosquitoes can hear the sound of the other persons. You can see clearly in the foldoscope images collected by reference of Manu Prakash. So this image was taken from that reference paper. So here we can see clearly the male Johnson argon of female Bushoff and male Bushoff has been clearly seen in this particular image. So variation of hair in female as well as male, how this variation and how these things are there. So here you can see clearly this is the white portion of the leg of mosquito. There is no hair particles are there, as well as in the dark portion there are more number of hair and bush of are visible in these two particular slides. This is the black portion and this is the white portion. In these two things we can understand this difference between interference pattern of hair seen in the leg. So they actually come from not a pigment but lack of hair in that location, which make it appearance white color. So this is the answer why it is looking into white color? Because of absence of hair and a present of hair in the dark side. So now we can see the structure of wing and how the aerodynamic portion, how it is seen in the microscopic level. So to understand the aerodynamics of the mosquito wings, this micro evolution of AIDS agita written by Louis C. will be explaining more amount of details. So this is in this slide, wing of one female mosquito was shown in figure A, and wing of geometrical pictographical and geometrical diagram was linking in the figure B. So now we can understand some of the images which we have taken under the microscopic level and what are their significances. So this is the image which I have taken in the foldoscope. It's looking like a blood structure of microscopic image of mosquito. So this is the blood of mosquito under foldscope. And similarly, this is the image which I have taken in the foldscope. This is the head of the mosquito. So this is the eyes of the mosquito, which you can see several number of eyes are there for the mosquitoes. This is a very, very, very clear understanding view of mosquito in foldscope. So this particular slide shows the wings of mosquitoes in mirror images. This is the first image. It's in mirror image I have kept in such a manner. So by that we can see a pattern of structure will be formed. Those things I have taken into a artistic phenomena and artistic knowledge of mosquitoes in microscopic level. So you can see there are many, many feather like structures, leaves like structures can be visible in this kind of images of wings. So this is also wing structures of another mosquito which looks in such a manner. So how and what kind of drawings we can draw from this kind of microscopic images can be seen in the upcoming slide. So this is the image which we have seen, the head of the mosquito. I have drawn from this particular image in which way the artistic phenomena can comes. So you can see the art which I am drawing in the outer layers, and it looks like a some kind of bird structure which it can be clearly visible for visualized in next. So this is the drawing which I have drawn by using that kind of capturing image. So this is the microscopy. I can say it can be used for art and understand the knowledge behind the images. So this is the images in mirror side I have drawn in such a manner. So this is the next image of wings I have taken, and I have framed the artistic phenomena of knowledge in which way it can be grasped. You can see clearly in a slow by slow the drawing structure and drawing pattern I have taken and collected, and it can be seen in next slide. So this is the art of the mosquito's wings. From that I made this pattern. So guys and children and students can be see the microscopic images, try to frame different kinds of drawing and artistic features. By that it can be helped to upcoming generation. This is another image of wings. In this the drawing I have drawn in such a manner. So guys, this kind of lecture series will be very much interested and very much useful for all upcoming generation to understand the microscopic images and its characteristics, and it will be useful for study purposes also. So some of the drawings of collected images in earlier lecture series and the present lecture series are displayed in this particular slide. So this is the references which was collected and which was used to develop this kind of lecture series. I can say a important note to all the students and all the viewers that next time if any mosquito buzzing around you, catch it and image it under the foldoscope. It can be used to identify species capable carrying a deadly diseases like dengue, malaria, as well as any other kind of things. It is the time to clean out any water logged areas around your house and try to be vigilant. Tell your neighbors sleep under bed nets. We can prevent many vector-borne diseases, but science advocacy have to be the heart of the solution. So this is the important note I can tell to all the students, all the children, to aware of the deadly diseases like dengue and malaria by capturing the mosquitoes and full scope imaging. Thanking you friends to see this particular video. Please subscribe my channel to understand the important concepts of microscopy and its artistic phenomena for understanding and gaining in the knowledge of microscopic level. Thanking you.